What is carbon sequestration? We have been talking so much about climate change, global warming. We know that the atmospheric levels of carbon dioxide have been rising over the years. But what can be done to mitigate it? So a good answer here is carbon sequestration. So let's identify the sources of carbon emissions and the method through which this sequestration could be done. We know there is carbon dioxide being released into the atmosphere through various sources. Pollution is one of the sources. Industrial exhaust is another source. Traffic fumes is another source. Then we have deforestation, that is another common example that we talk about. There are lots of natural activities as well as anthropogenic or man-induced or man-made activities that are there, which lead to higher amount of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. So what we try to do under carbon sequestration is a very simple process. We try to capture this whole carbon dioxide molecules that are seen in the atmosphere and we try to trap it. So those are the changes that would be seen through various methods that are there. Now, what are the methods of capturing this carbon has been really important to understand. But before we go into that, as we already mentioned, there are numerous sources of carbon in the atmosphere. Fuels, decomposition of plants and animals, deforestation, industrial exhaust, urban waste, and all of those accentuate the process of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. So here, as you can see, are some of the best methods or the remedies for carbon sequestration to be done. We would be focusing in on all of those one by one. So just to bring each of those on priority, we would be talking about all these methods in a sequence. So let's first talk about afforestation and reforestation. So definitely, forests are considered one of the best carbon sinks. If I'm cutting the forest, what would happen? The amount of carbon dioxide that the plants can take in order to give us oxygen would be reduced. So the process of photosynthesis would be reduced. And this would ultimately lead to higher amount of carbon dioxide being present into the atmosphere. So a good way is to plant more trees, and with planting of more trees, this carbon could be absorbed by the plants, and in return plants could provide us oxygen. Now worldwide forest under currently which we need to sequestrate in order to reduce the carbon dioxide emissions is where we say nearly 2 gigatons of carbon dioxide per year is currently being sequestered by the existing forest area that we have. If we are trying to plant new trees, if we are trying to replant the trees, we estimate that we could increase this further by 1 to 1.5 gigatons of carbon dioxide being absorbed, and the cost for the same process is very, very minimal. However, this would take years, because once you start planting the trees, the plant grows. It's a process of nearly 10 to 20 years for the minimum. The next method is carbon farming. Now, carbon farming is technically where we are trying to farm the carbon. So how we would farm it? We would have crops which would have deeper roots, deeper penetration of the roots. We would also incorporate more organic matter into the soil. The tilling would be increased for the soil, and therefore more carbon could be trapped in the soil. And this is used where we say there are certain trees which have a capability to actually store nearly more than 10 times the other crops. So identifying those crops and growing those crops is a method which is known as carbon farming. Again, carbon dioxide is not an issue just for land. We see higher amount of carbon dioxide in the water as well. So what could be seen is the coastal region could be developed. Now, when the coastal region comes into play, mangroves and seagrasses are excellent example, because they have a capability to sequester higher amount of carbon dioxide as compared to other crops or the vegetation that grows there. Now, how? This is because the oxygen poor soil in which they grow actually does not allow the carbon dioxide to go back into the atmosphere. And therefore, the recycling of the carbon takes place layer by layer over the centuries within the ocean. It is not being easily released into the atmosphere. And therefore, mangroves and seagrasses are considered as an excellent example for sequestering carbon. A lot of researchers have been going into it. We have seen that salt marshes are also one of the ways where sequestration could be enhanced. The next is bioenergy and BURI. Now, biocarbon capture and storage, the bioenergy carbon capture and storage, which is also known as BECCS, is one of the ways where I am converting the existing biomass into usable energy. So this could be converting the biomass into probably fuel or electricity. So generating fuel from, let's say, cow dung is one of the example, and this is how we say bioenergy. Now, in this process, rather than sending or releasing the carbon dioxide into the atmosphere, this is being trapped in a concrete container or a plastic container, and later on this whole carbon dioxide which is being trapped is injected back into the soil. However, this is a troublesome process, it is an expensive process, but yet it is under development. The researches are under development. I repeat again, the idea is very, very simple. We are using bioenergy or biomass to be converted into fuel. In this process, whatever carbon dioxide is being released is being kept into big concrete containers or plastic containers and later on injected into the soil system, so that it is not released into the atmosphere and prevents the global warming. So that is how carbon sequestration is done. A related strategy is also used in oceans. As we said, mangroves and seagrasses are one of these, but kelp is another way where carbon absorption is being done, and kelp is nowadays a complete food source which is considered as a new way of life for many. The next is biochar. Biochar is a way where the plant material is burnt, but it is not burnt fully. It is burnt at a very high temperature under low oxygen level, and therefore it is partly burnt. Now, this partly burnt carbon is basically rich in carbon, and it is being spread or being buried into the soil and has higher proportion of carbon in it. Why? The simple reason is I am burning this at higher temperature with low oxygen level. So the amount of carbon formed would be much higher, and this biochar, which is basically a pyrolyzed biomass, is another way to store or is another source where carbon could be actually burnt and stored in the soil. The next method that we talk about is fertilizing the oceans. What do you mean by fertilizing the oceans? A simple way is to help understand this is the ocean absorbs a lot of carbon dioxide every year. Now, how can I help ocean absorb more carbon dioxide? So, the availability of iron, the availability of some other nutrients or nitrogen, they need to grow, the bacteria need to grow, should be increased, and with that the amount of carbon dioxide that could be absorbed in the oceans would be increased, and this is what is known as fertilizing the oceans. So oceans are being used for more storage of carbon. The next is rock solutions. Now, this is simply where I am naturally removing the carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, and the reactions could be through the rainwater, through the rocks, and this removal is being artificially pushed into the systems, and there you have large cover where these carbon dioxide that is being released is being trapped. However, this is an expensive process and an energy intensive process, because you would require a lot of energy to to actually bury that carbon deep into the grounds, because it's an artificial process that you are trying to do. The next is direct air capture and storage. So the best way is the air that is there, rich in carbon dioxide, you capture that air, you store it either as solids or some other form and keep it in the underground storage. So once in the underground system, it would be over the millions of years, it would turn out into the fossil fuel. So you would have high amount of coal, petroleum, natural gas being formed there. So you directly capture the gas and bury it. You capture the gas from the atmosphere and bury it. But definitely this is not a practical solution, because plucking so much carbon dioxide or creating a system where you are separating from the atmosphere carbon dioxide. So rather than taking all the gases, I just need to have carbon dioxide. So I'll have to have a system or a mechanism to separate carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. That is not yet researched so much, and deploying that anywhere in the world would be a difficult solution or a difficult step that would be there. The next is a natural process where crushing of the rocks or a natural weathering process actually occurs, and this is being accelerated where carbonate formation takes place. So rather than having the loose carbon dioxide into the atmosphere, those turn out into carbonates, and these carbonates are the rock formation. So automatically the amount of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere would get reduced. The next important steps are some of the less heard ones, but yes, they obviously do exist. So carbon dioxide chemicals that are there, numerous chemicals have carbon dioxide as one of the constituents. For example, methanol, urea are some of the good examples. So creating more of those chemicals is one of the ways where you are not allowing the free carbon dioxide into the atmosphere and preventing the global warming greenhouse effect. The next is carbon dioxide being used as a fuel. So you combine hydrogen with carbon dioxide to produce, let's say, methanol or syngas or synfuel, and those would be one of the good ways of reducing the carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. The next is higher amount of microalgae. Microalgae again have a capability to fix the carbon dioxide, because algae have the capability to do photosynthesis, and microalgae are small algae that are present into the ocean surface, and since they are huge in number, we can have a significantly higher proportion of microalgae being present in the ocean. They can rapidly multiply and absorb huge amount of carbon dioxide. This is a possible and an interesting alternative that we have. Also, another good method nowadays that is being used is building concrete building materials out of carbon dioxide. So it is also known as the cure cement that is there. So this cement is basically curing the atmosphere. All the carbon dioxide is being trapped, and this is being used in the building material. So rather than letting the carbon dioxide go free into the atmosphere, we have the conventional cement that is being replaced by cure cement, which has higher amount of carbon dioxide being trapped in it. And the last one is the carbon dioxide enhanced oil recovery system, which is another common method where we are trying to enhance the oil recovery process, and in that we are trying to capture the carbon dioxide. Now these are some of the common methods that we have seen could be helpful for reducing the atmospheric carbon dioxide. But yes, we as a citizen have a responsibility to reduce the amount of exhaustion or the amount of carbon footprint that we are releasing into the atmosphere. And recently, Chandigarh has started with an app where an individual can monitor their carbon footprints, be it the traffic, be it the vehicles they are using, be it the water and the electricity consumption being used. So based on that, an individual can monitor the carbon footprint. So we as an individual can definitely work for methods where we reduce the carbon footprint. But for the research community trying to move forward with innovative methods for carbon sequestration is very, very important. And here are some of those that we have discussed. We would be covering many interesting lectures on environment. Stay tuned. Have a wonderful day ahead.